Well, I talk about four different risk factors when it comes to exercise. The lack of physical exercise. Again, 25% of the blood flow in your body goes to your brain. And when you exercise, not only does more blood get there, there's all different kinds of changes that go on in your brain that are very, very healthy and very, very positive for your brain. If you did nothing else, learned nothing else from the Alzheimer's journey, and exercised every day for 30 minutes, that would be probably be the best thing, the most effective thing you could do if you wanted to ignore everything else. Exercise, physical exercise, like it is for the rest of the body, is critical to the brain. How about mental exercise? There's a lot of literature out there now. There's a lot of programs out there talking about how to mentally exercise your brain, neurobics. Well, this includes not only after you get older, but it's your entire lifespan. A lot of data showing very clearly that when you mentally exercise your brain, keep it active, it stays healthy longer. And that makes sense, because when you're using your mind, using your brain, more electricity is flowing, more chemicals are flowing. So it's like a physical exercise, but it's mental exercise. The other type of exercise is emotional exercise. And you might think, how does emotional exercise affect your brain? Well, I'm a very big believer that emotional exercise, by that I mean crying and laughing in particular, that emotional exercises release stress on your brain. So it's a stress reliever. And finally, relational exercise. What do I mean by that? People who have less love in their life and less relationships in their life have a higher risk of Alzheimer's. Sounds crazy? Well, I'll talk about this in a lot more detail on a later day, but that's very clear. You need physical exercise, mental exercise, emotional exercise, and relational exercise.